Well, everyone in the mecha scene seems so obsessed with this temperature humidity sensor, the DHT22. Well, I'm no exception to that. So let's start. So what do we need? Of course, we need the sensor. We need an Arduino. We need resistors. And we need Dupont wires. The DHT22 has four pins. That one on the left is VCC pin. The one next to it is the data. The one on the outer right is ground. And this little feather we can ignore because it's not connected to anything. If you look in the internet for tutorials of this sensor, you find three different versions of it. Some tutorials say you have to connect the VCC, the ground and the data line to the Arduino directly, and the sensor would work. Some say, since this uses a one-wire library, you have to connect VCC and the data line. You have to connect VCC and the data line through a resistor. And now here's the interesting part. Some say you need a 4.7 kilo ohm resistor, and some say you need a 10 kilo ohm resistor. And if you look for the data sheet of this sensor, you also find both versions of the data sheet. So what we will do, we try every three versions. We try to connect it directly without a connecting resistor, and we try to connect with both values and see what works best for us. So let's wire it up. We connect the data line, pin 2, to a digital, let's say, digital 2. Of course, we need a ground line. Fourth pin. And in our first version, we connect the 5 volt directly to the sensor, pin 1. Let's see if this works. Well, business as usual. Let's see if we can find a library for the sensor. DHT. And here we got one from Adafruit. As good as it gets. So let's see for the examples. DHT sensor library. DHT tester. Well, this looks promising. We even use the same pin, the sketch, and the same sensor. So let's hook it up and see what we get. Well, it looks like it won't compile. It seems we need also the Adafruit Unified Sensor Library. And let's test it now. Well, this is the first test without any resistors. We have a humidity about 50% and a temperature about 22 Celsius. Well, let's check if this is values accurate. Well, I have here an analog temperature sensor. And it's also set 22 Celsius. And the digital one, let's see what is here. Okay, it's 24. Let's see if the resistors make any changes. So let's start by trying a 10 kilo ohm resistor, a pull-up resistor, between 5V and the data line. And let's run the serial monitor. Well, this is a test with a 10 kilo ohm resistor. And to be honest, I'm not seeing that kind of difference. Let's go for the 4.7 kilo ohm resistor. So we are done with our 10 kilo ohm resistor test. And let's move to our test with the 4.7 kilo ohm resistor. Also as a pull up between the data line and 5V. And let's see if there's any difference. Well, we are now at 4.7 kilo ohms. Hasn't changed much, hasn't it? Well, as we can see, the DHT22 works without a resistor, with a 10 kilo ohm resistor, with a 4.7 kilo ohm resistor. I even found a recommendation for a 1 kilo ohm resistor. And since this works with a 1 wire data bus, I recommend you also using 1 high value pull up resistor between VCC and the data line. But it really doesn't seem to matter the value of the resistor. I guess everything between 10 kilo ohms and 1 kilo ohm works fine. And what to do with it now? I guess I connect it to one of my ESP8266 IoT projects, so I can check the room temperature with my smartphone. If you wanted to see this project, leave a comment below, or if you know more details to the pull-up resistor for the DHT22, let me know in the comments. Bye!